Hello and welcome to NewsClick. I am Sumedha. Today we are talking about the handlooms and the handicraft sector. Apart from it, the sector being a concern of national pride and importance, the sector is also the second biggest employment generator in the country after agriculture. The reason why we're talking about the sector today is because it's facing enormous crisis, from constraints of budgetary allocations to government apathy and suppression of voices in the sector. So to discuss these concerns, we have with us Mohan Rao, sir. Thank you so much for joining us. He's been an activist for a very long time. He's also been a very, very important voice in the movement to raise these demands for the sector, and he represents the National Federation of Handlooms and Handicrafts. Thank you, sir, for joining us today.
Thank you, madam.
Sir, the sector is facing, like we've seen, an unprecedented crisis, and you've been speaking about it for very long now, and you've been very actively involved in the movement. Recently, the government of India, despite all these concerns, they decided to abolish two very important boards, the Handlooms and the Handicrafts Board. Two separate notifications were issued and these boards were abolished. So what kind of an impact have they had in terms of the movement, in terms of the voices of the craftspersons of our country, the weavers of our country who've been putting everything on the line?
Madam, all of the people knows about Handlooms is the second largest employment generation in India. More than 31.45 lakhs of people are engaged in this sector. And handicrafts, 68.86 lakhs of people are dependent on the handloom handicraft sector. Altogether, if you can calculate with multiply with 3% average family members, it is nearly 32 million of the people depends for their livelihood. But the government is not taking much interest, because of government is interested on financial economy, not the producer economy. Here, in this context, we should understand the financial economy, difference between the financial economy and producer economy. Yes. All cottage industries depends on the producer economy. Many people are engaged with these sectors, so that government ruining these sectors and desire to abolish this handloom board and handicrafts board. The history, the present government saying the Make in India and Made in India, they as a slogan, and vocal and local, but it is not interest for the traditional handmade producers.
Yes.
So they are interest more than handlooms and handicrafts. They are interest for the to protect the machine made products, but it should be made in India. Here in this context, I want to say a little bit about the establishment of the handloom boards and handicrafts boards.
Yes.
In the year of 1942, due to the crisis of the handloom sector, British government constituted a committee. It is fact-finding committee headed by the P.J. Thomas chaired. It is a three-man committee. They clearly mentioned about for the establishment of the handloom board and handicrafts board. In the year of 1945, it is established, but it is not functioned in dormant position. Why? Because in the year of 1948, our Indian Constitution Parliament resolved industrial policy. Through that industrial policy, it is they mentioned handlooms and handicrafts is strengthening the rural economy, so that we should give the priority to the handloom and handicrafts, and they constituted a standing committee on handlooms, so that handloom board is not function. It is comes under the purview of the cottage industries board. After intervention of the Prapul Jaikar and Kamala Devi Chattopadhyay ji, these two legends are the freedom fighters.
Yes,
they are closely involved in the freedom movement, and they are very much interested on the handicrafts. So they intervene to establishment of the handloom board and handicrafts board according to the recommendations of the fact-finding committee. In the year of 1952, it is constituted. It is very important till now, why it is important? In the fact-finding committee recommendations, they clearly says about to reserved some varieties of the handloom fabrics, which products made of coarser coat of yarn like chadar, towels, dhoti with width of 1/4 inch border, sari with 2.5 border, etc. The government passed this resolution through under the Cotton Textile Order Control Order 1948, but it is not implemented properly. This is the situation. Even though our Indian handloom sector facing a lot of problems, all the people knows very well, because of power loom, day by day power looms increasing, power loom units are producing with reserved items of the handloom.
Yeah,
and selling it the power loom product in the name of the handloom in the domestic market and giving the tough competition to the handloom products. This is the main reason. Another one reason is yarn prices is increasing day by day. There is no control regarding the yarn prices under textile control order. Nobody has taken any interest. It is not reviewed by the committees. It is a second problem. Another market linkage, market facility, it is not given by the government market facility. Our Indian market is the private, depends on the private economy, so that it is very difficult to the market for the handloom sector. And another credit facility, several times NABARD has given the guidelines for the credit facility to the handloom community and handicrafts. They constituted a 3-man committee and decided for the giving the credit loans for the handloom. Depends on the variety of the production. It is not properly implemented through the central cooperative banks, which is running under the guidelines of the NABARD and RBI. So these are all the faults of the government side.
And you recently had a press conference, and so many representatives from across the country, they came, and the federation organized this online press conference. So during the coronavirus pandemic, already the sector has been very hardly hit because of the virus and because of the lockdown. And what kind of voices did you get after this announcement? What has been the reaction of different activists, of different people on the ground?
Madam, all of the sharan, our honorable Prime Minister of India Modi ji called for the lockdown under health emergency guidelines.
Yes.
Before call the lockdown, government should not take any precautions to protect these small cottage industries like our individual unorganized sector people. So since March 24th to May 31st, end of May 31st, lockdown continued in phased manner in all over India. In this period, no work is provided by the master weavers as well as the cooperative societies. There is no raw material. All the people depends from the Tamil Nadu or Gujarat or Bombay for getting the yarn. All parts of India depends on these states. There is no mobility for the transport. So raw material crisis one side, another one side, accumulated huge stock is with the cooperatives and master weavers. There is no selling. All shops and retail and wholesale shops is closed. Not only one part, all parts of India it is closed. So immediately to provide the work, it is a difficult task to the cooperatives and master weavers also. It is one side. Another one side, government has given only regular ration. In addition to that ration, 1 month they have given 1,000 rupees in AP and Telangana. Some parts it is not happened in India. But regular ration is not sufficient to the communities, vacant sections, not only handloom and handicrafts. I am saying to all agriculture peasants and vacant sections who are below poverty line. So we demanded for another additional 3,000 rupees per month with regular ration.
Yes.
But unfortunately, it is not considered by the state or central government.
And sir, the budgetary allocations are anyway very constrained, right? So what has been the condition of the loans that were to be given by the government, or the budgetary allocations which the weavers are not getting, and the financial package which was supposed to reach them? So what has been the condition of that?
Yeah. Budget is very less, madam. Since many years, what is happening? I can say, for example, in the year of 2016 and 2017, budget allocated 505 crores of rupees, and the actual release is 483 crores and 92 lakhs. In the year of 2017 and 2018, budget allocated 397.7 crores and allocated 394 crores. But in the year of 2018 and 2019, 325 crores of rupees budget allocation, but actual release is 267.28 crores. In the year of 2019 and 2020, till date February, it is funds released 219.95 crores. But budget allocation is very less, even though release is also very less than the allocation of the funds. Yeah, for example, the welfare measures, only MG Mahatma Gandhi Bunkar Bhima Yojana, only 12.37% of the people covered under the Mahatma Gandhi Bunkar Bhima Yojana. And it is very less in the year of, it is 2016 and 17. But the same 2000 healthcare, Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana, only 11.04% people are covered because of very less budget for the welfare measures.
And the government and Modi ji specifically, they promote a lot of khadi, they promote Make in India quite a lot. But what is the real condition is a complete, like you're saying, it's a complete difference of the condition of the workers and the conditions of people who are actually trying to make in India and trying to promote khadi and our indigenous products.
Madam, slogan is different than real facts. Yeah. In the grassroots level, everybody knows about the meaning of Make in India. At the time of the freedom struggle, in the year of 1905, before the Elphinstone building, the so-called Dadabhai Nauroji and Lala Lajpat Rai, Bipin Pal, they called for the boycotts of the foreign goods. At that time, all our Indian citizens, with the spirit of this slogan and dedicated personalities, struggled against the foreign goods like clothes, cigarettes, powders, oils, utensils, etc. But at that time, we have no dumped foreign goods in the domestic market.
Yes.
We are against to that. We have no other industries to survive our livelihoods. But now, many multinational companies dumping their goods in the domestic market. Our market share, more than 60% captured by the multinational companies. It is not recognized by the government. In this context, I want to say to the public, through this interview, Make in India means they are allowing machine made products also, but which machine is possible to allow our Indian manufacturing units is okay. But unfortunately, what is happening, foreign sophisticated machinery dumping in India and establishing the units in our India and making the products. It is also called as a Make in India. What is the meaning with Make in India? Without machine manufacturing in India, our own, and manufacturing with the local raw material, available raw material, it is okay for us. It is meaningful. Otherwise, dumping the machinery, sophisticated machinery from abroad, and dumping the raw material from abroad according to their requirement of the machines, we don't agree. My personal opinion, I am not agree with this slogan. So it is false statement. even Khadi people are also suffering. Individual Khadi weaver or Khadi yarn producer also suffering. Why? Because recently government has taken, government has issued a GO who are registered with the central government under Khadi commission. They are recognized as a Khadi people, Khadi producer, who are not registered with the Khadi commission. Those people are not recognized by the Khadi, but huge number of Khadi people are not recognized by our government.
And sir, so what are the demands now? What should be the way forward to ensure the protection to our own people, to our own products?
Government should provide the raw material through the NHDC for the handlooms, through establishment of the production and procurement for the handicraft sector. It is very urgent need for establishment of the production and procurement centers, both handlooms and handicraft. Otherwise, lakhs of people will suffer and thousands of people will die in future. The situation is very deep, in deep crisis continuation in our country.
And what are the other ways in which you will, as an activist, also try to ensure that the voices which are being suppressed in the sector because of the abolishment of the boards, how is the movement now going to take shape, and if there are protests which are planned, and what is the plan to sort of raise the voices against these policies of the government?
We are planning for collective bargaining.
Okay.
Collective bargaining is most important in these conditions. Why? Because different states having different issues in different level. But ultimately, we have to pressurize the political will.
Yes.
Without political will, nothing will happen in our democratic country. Maybe it is somebody, is it democratic? It is a question of democracy also. Our democracy constitution has provided Article 43 and 43A and Article 41 for providing the work within the limits of the state economic conditions, but it is not happening particularly for the handlooms and handicrafts. It is simply ignoring the each and everything which is related to the handlooms and handicraft sector. For example, I can give one example. More than 67% people are getting below 5,000 rupees on handloom sector. It is recognized by the central government. It is mentioned in the fourth handloom census of 2019 and 20. It is clearly mentioned. More than only below 27% of the people are getting below 10,000 rupees. How we can say the conditions of, can you imagine this? People are not taking even two full meals in some states. They are not getting even 150 rupees per day. But if you can observe the Mahatma Gandhi employment guarantee scheme, they are getting 203 rupees per day. But even handloom weavers and handicrafts are working more than 10 hours, even though they are not able to get 150 rupees per day as average. This is the situation. So we are demanding the government, central government, through your interview, to allocate the funds under Atmanirbhar Bharat. Government announced 20 lakhs of crores rupees for the under Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan package, but even single pie is not allotted for the handloom sector and handicraft sector. This is the partiality. Why? Because it is happening. We are not citizens of India. We are the citizens of India. We are having the right to ask the, to demand the government. We are having the right to right to work.
So on that note, sir, thank you for giving us such an extensive view of what is the condition in the sector. We really appreciate it, and we will continue to follow it up here on NewsClick. Thank you so much for watching. You